Hello, praise the Lord. In Lamentation chapter 3 verse 22 and 23 we find that it is of the Lord's mercy that we are not consumed, because his compassion fell not, they are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, saith my soul, therefore will I hope in him. So in Lamentation 3:22-23 we find that Lord's mercy. Because of Lord's mercy we are not consumed. Because of Lord's mercy we are not killed. Because of Lord's mercy we are alive. We are saved from all type of danger, all type of diseases and all type of problems. And his mercy is great, his faithfulness is great. And it is written, they are new every morning and great is thy faithfulness. His faithfulness is very great. And his faithfulness is very great. That's why we are not consumed. We are not killed. That's why it is written, therefore will I hope in him. We have a hope in him that his faithfulness is great. We should depend upon his faithfulness. In Hebrew chapter 13 verse 5 we find, keep your lives free from the love of money and be content with what you have, because God has said, never will I leave you, never will I forsake you. God will never leave us. God will never forsake us. Those who love us today, they may forget tomorrow, or they may forget in time of our danger. When we are in real dangers, people forget us. People are not with us. They forsake us in real dangers. We have seen, you might have seen, and all have experienced this, that in real danger people forgets us, people forsake us. But God will never leave us, as we find in Hebrew 13:5, that never will I leave you, never will I forsake you. God will never forsake us. Any man can forsake us, but God will never forsake us. Even our parents may forsake us, they may forget us, as we find in Isaiah chapter 49:15, it is written like that, can a mother forget the baby at her breast and have no compassion on the child she has born? Though she may forget, but I will not forget you. God is not going to forget us. He is not going to forsake us, because his faithfulness is great. A mother usually loves her child very much, more than her life. But sometimes there are examples that they forget their child. They forget their child. Intentionally or unintentionally, they forget their child. They forsake their child for some reason. That happens. That is possible. But it is not possible that God will forget us or forsake us. He will not forsake us, not forget us. So a mother can forget a child. It is possible that a mother can forget a child, forsake her child. But God is not going to forget us, and he is not going to forsake us. In Ephesians chapter 3 verse 17 and 19 we find that Christ may dwell in your hearts by faith, that ye being rooted and grounded in love may be able to comprehend with all saints, that is the breadth and length and depth and height, and to know the love of Christ which passeth knowledge, that ye might be filled with all the fullness of God. Now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. So Christ may dwell in our hearts by faith. Christ dwells in our heart by faith. When we have faith in Lord Jesus Christ, then Christ comes in our heart. He is knocking at our heart and he wants to come inside our heart. And if we by faith accept Lord Jesus in our heart, then he will lives in our heart. And when he will live in our heart, then we'll grounded in love. We'll have love for others. We'll have love for other saints. We'll be longing to have fellowship with other saints. And with that fellowship, we need to understand, comprehend, fathom the breadth and length and depth and height. It is so deep, it is so high, it is so long, it is so wide that it is difficult to comprehend. It is difficult to imagine how much He has shown His love upon us. So it is written that we need to try to find out how much He has loved us. It is beyond our descriptions. It is beggar descriptions. We cannot describe that. It is so much He has loved us that it passeth knowledge, and who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we ask or think. Beyond our imagination, He do goods to us. He has compassion on us. He has kindness on us. He answer our prayers. Even though sometimes we do not ask certain things, but He gives us voluntarily. So His love is so great. His love is so high. His love is so deep. His love is so long. His love is so wide. It is so much. It is difficult to comprehend in our human possibility. So we need to try. We need to know that He has loved us so much. In Psalms 121, we find that I will lift up mine eyes unto His hills. From whence comes my help? From where our help comes? Our help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth, who had made this, who had created this earth, who had created this heaven. That God helps us. That God has faithfulness on us. So it is written that He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, He that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in from this time forth and even forever. In Philippians, we find that what God has started in us, He will also going to complete us. And through Him, we can overcome. We can overcome the world. And He has written in John 16 that He has overcome the world. So we need to have faith in Him. And he will keep us. He will protect us from all danger, all type of temptations. And it is written that He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. And in verse 4, Psalms 121, verse 4, we find, behold, He that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. He neither slumber nor sleep. He always guards us, always looks upon us, always sees us. He always is careful for us. He is very much careful for us. And when He will slumber, if he will slumber, if he will be asleep, then we will be in danger. The world will be destroyed. So He never slumbers. He never sleeps. He always guards us. We have such a faithful God. So we need to have hope in Him. And His faithfulness is so great. In Psalms chapter 108, verse 4-5, we find, and there, for thy mercy is great above the heavens, and thy truth reacheth unto the clouds. Be thou exalted, O God, above the heavens, and thy glory above all the earth. He should be exalted, He should be praised, He should be worshipped, because His mercy is so great. It is above the heavens. That means it is higher than heavens. It is greater than heavens, because He has forsaken the heaven, all authority, all power, because of us. And was born in a poor family, in a carpenter family, and suffered all kind of difficulties, all type of sufferings, all type of blame, and all type of torture He went through to save us, to give us salvation, to forgive us. So, see, his love is, His kindness is, His mercy and His faithfulness is higher than heaven. It is greater than heaven. He did not mind the power. He did not mind the heaven. He did not mind the comfort of heaven. He left it because of us. That's why it is greater than also heaven. His love is greater than heaven, he can create another heaven. But he loves us greater than heaven. He loves us more than he loves heaven. So his faithfulness is great, his love is great, his mercy is great, his compassion is great. And we find in Psalms 103:11-12, for as the heaven is high above the earth, so great is his mercy toward them that fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath he removed our transgression from us. So as the heaven is high above the earth, heaven is so much higher than earth, we cannot comprehend it, we cannot measure it, and beyond that his mercy. Those who fear him, those who fear God, his mercy is great. As far as east is from the west, so far hath he removed our transgression from us. He has removed our transgression. He does not remember that. He has forgotten all our sins. He has forgiven all our sins. He does not remember that. If he will remember, he may be ashamed. That's why he does not remember that. In Psalms 145, we find the Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger and great in mercy. The Lord is good to all, and his tender mercy are over all his works. His mercy is greater than all his works. His mercy is great. His compassion is great. In also Psalms 103:13, like as a father pitieth her children, so the Lord pitieth them that fear him. If we fear him, if we worship him, if we obey him, his pity also is great. His compassion is great. His faithfulness is great. His love is great. We cannot measure it. It's so great. So his faithfulness is great, and it is new every morning. So we need to thank him for that. There is a song, Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Let us sing that song for the glory of God. Great is thy faithfulness, O God my Father. There is no shadow turning with thee. Thy change is not, thy compassions they fail on. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning new mercies I see. Their process evolve, join with all nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy and love. That is thy faithfulness, that is thy faithfulness. Morning by I see all I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Pardon for sin and a peace that endureth. Thine own dear presence to hear and to guide. Strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings all mine with 10,000 beside. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. you for your patient hearing. May God bless you.